And what I want to do is play this song right here, and it's called Freedom, if you know John Batiste, and if you don't, it's still called Freedom. And I want you to go ahead and just move your body any way you feel at all, okay? This, if you want to do anything as bold as dance, go ahead and dance. But if you just want to sit there and kind of move, that's what this is about. We're going to play some music, and you all express a little bit of your freedom. Here we go. Anything you're feeling, just move your hands, move your head, move your feet. That's it. That's exactly right. The hands are up. That's right. Roof, guys. That's right. That's the hands. Where did the street go? Oh, I like it. Yeah. I'm watching at home. I can see you. You're moving with us. Can express. Anyone ever feel that the English language is really limited for expression? Yeah, you're not right. So that was gorgeous. Feel free to get it. Just express space. Why else? Why do we play music to get started, you think?
It takes us outside of ourselves.
That's it. Right? We literally walked into a door here and we're in a new place. And, you know, comfortable, uncomfortable, whatever it is, we've got the outside world in it. That's the transformation. The music just says, okay, I'm here. Beautiful. Good. Anybody else? Why we play music? Remember, no wrong answers, so anything you say is good. Keep it in mind. You feel free to say anything as we're doing this because that's a demonstration of how improvisation works. This isn't about me telling you how this works. I'm going to put some stuff out in front of you and you're going to tell me how it works. That's the cool thing about this, all right? So what is improvisation? Maybe you've heard of it or seen it before. What do you think it is?
Spontaneous,
I heard.
People don't know what's coming, they just get words or something, then they have to make something of it.
There you go, get words or something, have to make something of it. Good, all of that, that works really well. Well, here's a definition that we like to use, and I think it's pretty elegant. Unplanned collaborative response via yes and. So let's talk about that first part, okay? Unplanned. Like you said, we don't know what's going to happen next. Here's the part not a lot of people think about, collaborative. This happens together. And I hope that's just a big load of bricks falling off your shoulders. Because at this moment, that's, oh, you mean I'm not up here to do stand-up? I'm not up here to entertain? I'm not here to, you know, make someone else? No, no, no. This is back and forth. If I threw you a ball, I'm going to throw you a ball, what do you think you might do with that ball now? You kicked it over there, beautiful. It was a back and forth, and he did something natural with it. He said, here's what I'm gonna do. It was an exchange, though, right? That was there naturally for us. We didn't have to define it. We didn't have to put rules around it. That was collaborative. And then response, okay? This is where we trust the thing that comes to us. Rather than stop and think about the right thing, we say, this is how I feel. This is what's here. And that's where the good stuff happens. We're going to keep exploring that. So unplanned collaborative response via yes and. We're literally exercising yes and. We're going to keep saying that in different ways and see where can yes and take us, okay? In the framework of Parkinson's, here's how I want you to think of yes and. Yes is the acceptance that Parkinson's is in your life, okay? That's the truth. In some fashion, it's in all of our lives. And within the community, maybe you know this, a lot of people have a hard time getting to that place. It's not fun, even when you know it's the truth, to accept it. However, that truth allows you to get to and. Yes, the truth delivers you to and is where you have influence, you have power. Until you accept yes, you can't get to and. So yes and exercise, that's where you transform, all right? So that's where we're at. Now, if Parkinson's has ever been thought of as rigidity, who's heard about that part of you, or maybe experienced, right? Think of improvisation as fluidity. You're welcome to come join us if you like down here, or stay there, whatever you're comfortable with. So think of improvisation as fluidity, okay? This, like dopamine, is going to provide you the opportunity to become more and maybe even explore parts of yourself you hadn't understood. All right? Here's a phrase we use, trust and embrace the unknown. Okay? Take your time. If you need a hand.
He just wants to scoot over more.
Absolutely. Love having you center stage. It's where you belong. Trust and embrace the unknown. How do you feel about that phrase? How does it make you feel when you hear that?
Safety.
You feel safety. Good.
I got an adventure.
Adventure. That's nice. Good. Anybody else? Trust and embrace the unknown. What does it make you feel?
A little bit scared.
A little bit scared. All of that is so valid. And did we hear? We heard different perspectives. It all works. No wrong answers, okay? This is what improv, through the exercise of yes and, is going to get us comfortable with doing. Trust and embrace the unknown. We don't know the next thing that's going to happen, and we're going to go ahead, admit that, yep, I don't know that, and I'm going anyway. That's the definition of courage, right? Not just saying, nothing scares me, that's not courage. That's foolhardy, right? Courage is, that terrifies me, and I'm doing it. That's courage. All right. So it's more than words. Remember what we were saying earlier? Sometimes we think of improv as only coming up with witty things. And often maybe, who's seen Whose Line Is It Anyway, right? You've seen that, right, you've seen it. Those men and women are wonderful. However, that's only one form of improvisation. I don't want anyone to think of it like I have to be that in order to participate in improvisation. It's naturally part of who you are. And again, your emotions and your senses are all gonna be part of that. And one way we express that is through this really simple game called Mirror. So here's what I'd like you to do. I'd like you to act like you're my mirror. You're going to reflect me. I'm going to make some very simple movements, and you're going to reflect me, okay? So let's see what we can do. If you see that, exactly, however you want. Whatever you see is correct, okay? Perfect. You're doing a great job. Great. What I'm going to have you do in a minute is I'm going to call switch, and you're going to look at somebody else, anybody else, and you're going to start either following or leading in that direction, okay? So when I call switch, you pick someone else, all right? And you're either going to follow or lead with them. Let's see what happens. And switch. Oh.
There's three of us.
Yeah. We don't know.
I'll do you. You do me.
Ah. Switch. And switch. And good. All right, everybody come back. Good job. Give yourself a round of applause. What happened in that game of Mirror? What were you feeling? Why do you think we played that?
with it.
Nothing more needs to be done. That's the end, folks. We're done.
It's fun.
It really is.
There's control there. You just, right?
Good. You felt some control. That's nice.
Mm-hmm. Well, so, the other thing is there was a decision that needed to be made over here, here, and here about who was going to do it, and I just jumped right in, and they followed.
That's awesome. And by the way, is it more correct to be a leader or follower?
No, it doesn't matter.
This man gets a gold star.
You kind of switched on.
Yeah,
that's it. If you feel like more of a leader in your life, improv's a great place to try being a little bit more of a follower. If you feel like more of a follower in your life, improv's a great place to try being a little more of a leader. It'd be lovely to have that balance so that we can step into the situations as they arise and say, oh, this calls for leadership. Oh, this calls for servant leadership. This calls for following, whatever it is, right? We want to be at that level of equality within ourselves. And power, that really is power, to be that place, to not be stuck always as, I'm leading no matter what anyone says, mine. Or I'll just do what everyone says. We don't have to be either. It can be a yes and. All right? Good. So this is a list here, and I don't know how well you'll be able to read these, but if you can see them at all, or I'll give you some of them. Specificity, listen, auga, fail big, today's the day, be effective, discovery, transformation, fall in love. Any of those words, if one of those just jumps out at you, just raise your hand and tell me which one, and maybe, you know, we'll say why. There you go, she's got one. Yes, go ahead.
Fall in love.
Oh, fall in love, perfect.
What's the last one?
The last one is covered up. It's a secret one. I can't tell you.
Oh.
that's Google Slides being Google Slides. Listening is loving. Second one there. Yes, and color that in for me. I declare, I notice, I feel, I heard you say, I see you, I see me, you have a, and justify. Who's got one? What's speaking to you for whatever reason at all?
I see you.
I see you. Good. And what does that mean to you, I see you?
It means that I see beyond the facade that you're showing me, and I see you as a person inside.
Wow. Seeing the whole person. That's beautiful. Right? Again, no right or wrong. These are things to inspire us in the world of improv. Here we go. Here's another lesson. Play, back and forth, give and take, think versus react, say, fail for fun, irrational bliss. Point to the fun. I've got your back, and do your work early. Who's got one? Don't think too hard.
Do your work early.
Do your work early. Talking about do your work early.
So that you can play later.
I love it! Right? That's part of the yes and, accepting the reality of it's in front of you, and it frees you up to play when you need to. Great. Last one, last list. Let's look at this. There it is. Give a gift or accept a gift. Follow the fear, fun, failure. F it. No jokes. Trust the unknown. Lone nut, first follower. Commit to it. Pour gas on it. Joy, juxtaposition, permission, and hope. Who's got one?
Well,
there she is.
I heard you say pour gas on joy.
Oh.
And I was like, yeah, I'm there.
Do it! That's exactly it. Pour gas on joy. You're putting these together. All of these interconnect. All of these are yes and opportunities everywhere. And I love that you loved pour gas on joy. Because why? What does that do for us?
I mean, it amplifies the joy.
Why not? More joy. Joy is one of the great outcomes, the desired outcomes for improv, the way we play. That's really, in fact, you're all invited any time that this program we play every Tuesday morning, and they'll be expanding, but at 10 o'clock Pacific, online, which is most of where this program takes place, called the Jam for Joy. And that's what we do for an hour. We get together and we just play games, and it has some of this format in it, and it's free. We'll talk about later the structure of what we do. We're a 501c3. We want this to be there for you to pour gas on joy. I can't tell you how much I love that.
I thought of it as an opposite. It's to burn up joy so it's not around anymore.
Oh, now see, that's possible. You can see it that way. It's possible too. So if we saw it as burning it up, that could be. And by the way, improv plays all things. Sometimes we get out feelings that have to do with fear, that have to do with anxiety, that have to do with depression. We be very real about those things. This is not a Pollyanna thing, like everything's great all the time. It's okay to experience the entire spectrum of our feelings. In fact, it's not only okay, it's necessary. Because really, when we get to this thing that we call truth in comedy, one of the ideas in improvisation, the funniest stuff happens when we reveal that vulnerable pain, and we go, yeah, me too. I'm going to yes and that because I know what you feel. And all of a sudden, we become a community at a deeper level. All right? Good. I bring this list forward. to say to you, this is just some of the lexicon, and we start, you're already doing, you're playing with what's up there. You start to use these words, and then you use them in ways, they're not my list, I didn't invent them, okay? They're just words I picked out over the years of doing this that are meaningful, that help give people signposts to play in this land of improvista, whatever it is, okay? We explore this together, and these are ways that help us get to that position of play. Great job. So there's the big power word play. Have any of you ever heard of a guy named Dr. Stuart Brown? He's considered the godfather of PhD level play, okay? And I'm very geeky about this stuff now because I'm nearing my dissertation to, you know, turn that in and I'll be Dr. Robert soon. And play is a very important part of improvisation. Play is something that we, as a society, say, great that kids do it. Not so much for adults. And Dr. Brown argues that's completely irresponsible. Play is not something to do only when we're allowed to. Play is something to do to develop our better self. This is where we uncover the new ways of doing things, new ways of thinking, new ways of empowerment. It's through play. It's through accepting that we have that childlike part of us that is legitimate and doesn't need to be ashamed, put to a corner, any of those things. It needs to, in fact, be celebrated, have some, you know, positive gas poured on it so it doesn't burn up, but is, in fact, proliferated. So some people think of improvisation, how many of you think of it as a performance, something like this? You would come and sit there and you would see people up here, right? And this is a great place, Comedy Sports, to see that professional improvisation. What I want you to know within the Yes and exercise world is we're not about that. We're not about making you into performers. This is about everybody playing and not needing to have that. So if there's anxiety about, I'm not sure if that's for me, if I'm gonna be on the spot or have to be funny, I wanna do everything I can to relieve that from you, okay? I like this phrase. This is one I heard from one of my teachers back at Second City. He said, the person that gives the most wins. Think of improvisation that way. You're constantly, how can I make you look better? What can I give you that helps you feel comfortable, happy, full of joy? That's what we're doing. That's the person that wins, constantly giving the assist. And this is a shout out to Marianne Rambo, my friend over there. Point to the fun, okay? We always want to look to what other people do and say to them, that's great. I love your shirt. I love your shoes. I love your energy. I love you being here, being my pal, okay? All of these things, I'm pointing to the fun. Pointing to the fun, saying thank you, thank you, and thank you. That allows you to come in and play, all right? And that is why we play this next game called You, and it's very simple. Here's how we're gonna do this. I'm gonna point at someone, and I'm gonna say you. And because my wife has an Italian-Sicilian background, she likes the mafia movies, and she likes the way they say it in the mafia movies, which is kind of like, you, okay? Like you're letting that person know. You can play that way, or you say you any way you like. But I want you to pass that you, because if you're holding the you, that means we're not playing. Right? It's stuck with somebody. So when I pass you the you point at somebody else and you say you. And as soon as you feel the you to you, you pass the you to somebody else. And I want you to pass this you around, okay? Here it comes, and you're looking right at me, so it's got to be you.
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 Any of us, the gift is about all of us, and it is about sharing at all times, and by letting that person know, you are special to me, you are, I see you, okay? Make it all about the other person. Okay, so what's in it for me? Enough about you, talk about me. Well, within a Parkinson's world, we talk about non-motor symptom improvement. Parkinson's is often defined, and I think somewhat limitingly so, as a motor disorder, okay? That's part of it. However, the non-motor symptoms are at least as prevalent and at least as problematic, okay? When we're talking about anxiety, stress, depression, communication issues, isolation. All of these things fall into the non-motor side. And that's things improv does extraordinarily well. It helps invite in community. It helps people feel seen, heard, trusted, respected, loved, all right? And able to therefore grow and discover what else they might like to be. It's more support than social. So sometimes the criticism has been within the research is, well, isn't that just getting together to be social? It's more than that. Creativity, three C's, creativity, communication, and, oh wait, there's a third C. Someone give me a C word, I'll see if it fits.
Creativity,
communication, confidence, aha! Confidence. These are things that we have shown through our clinical trials, improvisation can help manifest, help people feel these things, okay? Creativity, communication, confidence. So it's not as simple as simply being together. Support groups are great for what they do. At the same time, support groups can be a little bit limiting depending on the leader or depending on the group because it may become about the symptoms or the negative things people are going through, which are important to talk about. We keep things in a forward yes and motion. Of course, if you're coming in with a bad day, a poor symptom, a bad outcome, those things get brought in and we yes and them into a space where, believe it or not, we end up laughing about even some of the most painful things because we recognize we're in it together. So it's more than social, okay? Keep that in mind. And then what that allows for, well, we discover who and what we may have either forgotten about ourselves or never even imagined, and we can transform into those things right on the spot. Improv says yes and right now. It's about being together, and it's about being present. Whatever happened before, we left it go with freedom. Whatever's going to happen in the future, we're not worried about right now because we're right here. This is where we are. And that's where we have the power to make those transformations. So we're going to play a game right now, and it's called What's in the Box. So what I want you all to do is to hold an imaginary box in your hands, okay? Good. And yeah, it could be any shape or size. That's wonderful. What's going to happen is I'm going to ask you that question. I'm going to ask you the question, what's in the box? And I want you, this is the important part, look down and look up. And when you look down, you see it, you look up, you say it, okay? And you're all gonna say it with full voice, whatever you've got, we can say it all at once, that's fine, okay? So go ahead and hold that box, make sure you look down, and then see it, and then look up and say it. And don't think too hard about it, you see it, you say it. Here we go. What's in the box?
Buffalo.
Cabbage.
Excellent, look again, here we go. What's in the box?
A kitten.
Hershey bar.
A bucket.
Ice.
A warm fuzzy.
Beautiful. I love warm fuzzies. Here we go. What's in the box?
A trimble.
Good. I hear these big voices. Keep shouting them out.
Birthday present.
I love it. Here we go.
World peace.
Oh, look at that. What's in the box? I heard world peace. I like that to go with the world
lamb
peace.
Lamb cutlet.
Beautiful. Look again. What's in the box?
Homework.
A new baby.
Wheat.
Yes. One more time. What's in the box? Ooh.
Jello.
Brownies. Goes with the world peas and the brownies. You know, more often than not, it ends up being food in the box. I have to admit it. We're all we're savory creatures. What did you discover and or hear within that game, What's in the Box, just now?
Volume.
Variety.
Beautiful. Did anything surprise you that either you saw or heard from someone else?
I noticed that sometimes when someone said something, it influenced me a little bit.
Ah, good. And how do you feel about that, being influenced by others? Is that okay?
That's
okay. Yeah. That's within the improvisation, we want you to be comfortable with phones falling or with any of those things can be yes-handed, absolutely. That we're here to create safe, brave space, okay? Safe, brave space. We want to be here together to say whatever needs to be said and to recognize that we're going to be brave in that space. We may not like everything that's going to be said. However, we're going to be respectful within that and we're going to be courageous in there and offer our truth to that space, all right? So what is the box? I mean, what is it actually, you know, it's representing something, which is, what do you think the box is?
starter.
A starter? Good.
I was thinking of something like my feelings or
your
my feelings. Thoughts.
Your yeah. thoughts. Wonderful.
It's a vehicle for giving.
It is a vehicle for giving. I love all of these answers. Again, no wrong answers. I guess out of all that to just say it's our brain, right? It's a download of our head. It's kind of our thoughts, right? That our stuff that's in here, we can get it out and manifest it here. And all of a sudden, when we play that game, and by the way, you can play a game either by yourself or anywhere. You take all these games. They're very simple. Try them out. We can loosen ourselves up. We loosen up that creativity. And sometimes as people have played this game, they've seen things they didn't like in the box. And we want to encourage through this is to let them know it's safe to let us know. And sometimes people have said, reported, there's nothing in the box. And they get very upset about that. They feel like I'm not creative or I don't have it in me. And I tell them to say yes and to that. And I had a woman who I call my first follower who looks at that and she saw white fog and it frustrated her forever. She says, there's nothing there, it's just white fog. I say yes and to that. It's white fog. Good, and go ahead and tell me what's in the fog. Will you yes and to that? Oh, I can do that? Sure you can do that. And she explored the fog, and she found some mud, and started sucking her down. You know, we went in a whole journey, and it was great. So saying yes and to ourselves and to each other can lead to all kinds of discovery and transformation. Oops, I don't need that guy. Well, now, wait, there's more for me? There's more? Yes, of course there's more. That's what this is about. Dopamine and oxytocin. We know about these lovely things within us, right? The love hormone being oxytocin. Through this kind of communication, we feel good. These are things that actually chemically shift inside of us, and we produce more of them to have improved mood. That's a real benefit. That's measurable. And here's one that I heard first from my friend Pat. He said this quote here from David Augsburger, that being heard is so close to the feeling of love for the average person, they are indistinguishable. That's what listening, which I think was one of the things you called for, right? Listening is loving. That's what it feels like to really truly be listened to. And that's why we play that way at that level, is we want listening to happen at such a way, because normally, not normally, but maybe in regular everyday life, how many people feel like surface level conversation, transactional, is more the way you go? I need this, I can provide that. You need that, okay, you can do that. Does that sound like kind of a regular, mechanical way of getting by? Right. You're maybe not expressing all of your needs or feelings, and maybe the other person wasn't ready to hear them anyway. When you feel fully heard, what does that feel like? When someone really listened to you and actually heard how you felt, and by the way, said yes and to that, allowed for that, what does that feel like to be fully heard? I see you nodding.
Loved and warm and understood.
That's lovely. Loved and understood. That's so good. That's so good.
Validated.
Validated. There's
That's
a great
the word I was trying to think of.
It's an excellent word. Validated. What you say feel matters.
We're married. We thought of the same word.
Beautiful. Validated together. Excellent. Well, good. This is another game that plays into that. This is called What's Not Wrong With Your Life? And so I'm going to ask you that question, and again, you're just going to shout that out, okay? You don't need to hold up a box or anything this time. You're just going to answer that question over and over again, okay? I'm going to ask you for a little bit, and you just say the first thing comes to your mind. Now, right now, you've got about three or four answers in your head. You can throw those away if you like, or you can go ahead and throw them to me. We'll work past them. But I'm going to ask you, and you just go ahead and shout it out, okay? Anything at all. Here we go. What's not wrong with your life?
Rich.
Carol.
What's not wrong with your life?
Swimming.
Breathing.
Good.
Good food.
What's not wrong with your life?
Smiling.
Water.
And food.
Good. What's not wrong with your life?
Dessert.
Good. Flowers. Yes. Gardening. What's not wrong with your life?
Health.
Walking, exercising.
Excellent. What's not wrong with your life?
Company.
Why do you think we play that game? Different question. Why do you think we play that game?
I think of the positive things instead of all the negative.
Is it something where, do you ever feel like you get caught up in a negative loop thinking about it? Yeah, me too. I do. Anybody else? Why do we play that game? That's a great answer. How about the word gratitude, which kind of summarizes what you said? Does anyone feel like they could use some more gratitude as a feeling in their life? I mean, I know I can. To be thankful, right, for what we have. It's easy to focus on the negative, and it's not to say those things aren't true. It's just to say that the gratitude, this is an exercise in gratitude, and something you can both play by yourself and play with your partner at any given time. And watch how it makes you feel once again. It can absolutely relieve you of a negative loop, a negative cycle. Okay? Something very, very utilitarian, okay, you can take with you. Now, when you think of what Yes Exercise is, think of it like, you anyone know those companies, 3M, BASF, you ever heard of them?
Cassettes.
Yeah, that's one of the things they did, or do, I should say. Their line is, I hope it comes up here, there it goes, we don't make the product, we make the product better. Okay? Yes, and exercise, improv in general, is about that. It's not going to change you, right? But it's going to help improve those pieces of you. It's going to help you see things differently. We call this yes, and exercise, but it's not like rock steady boxing or dance for Parkinson's. We're not trying to replace or compete with either of those things, or yoga or Tai Chi or any other. This is a different approach. It's going to put you in a mindset or a mood to where at the end of it, you're going to say, I'm ready to go to my rock steady boxing class. I'm ready to go to my dance for PD. This is going to push you in that direction. It's going to make you want those things, okay? So it's not a traditional exercise. However, some of these testimonials give you a feeling for what people have felt when they've done it. This gentleman, Rhett, said, the exercises fire out parts of my brain that others otherwise would be dark and silent, and maybe even beginning to atrophy. Pieces that just haven't been used for whatever reason. I felt like I didn't have Parkinson's for the last 90 minutes, said Jody, right? To get that relief. And the research is pretty clear. Maintaining social connections and reducing isolation has a dramatic effect on quality of life. And that's Paulie Dawkins, a friend from the Davis Finney Foundation. So that's it. All of these things play through what we're doing and how we do this, all right? It's really important that we come to. Now, we talked about our emotions earlier. How many of you heard of this woman before? Brené Brown, you ever heard of her as a researcher? She's one of my spirit animals right now, I love her. And she says, we like to think we are rational beings who occasionally have an emotion and flick it away. But we are emotional, feeling beings who on rare occasions think, right? And I think that's really nice sentiment. It helps us, again, reset and reframe. Oh, we like to think of ourselves as logical. Meanwhile, we're over here being emotional and acting like it doesn't matter or exist. So we play with emotions for that reason. Let me ask you, how many emotions do you think we have in our spectrum? If you had to guess.
22.
22?
Good. I was thinking maybe it's not even connected to words, that those emotions just happen and we don't have markers for them.
We don't have markers for them. They're out there. There's more than we have markers for them, maybe. That's a reasonable answer, absolutely. Anybody else, thoughts on maybe how many we have? Well, here's the thing. Brené's done a lot of research on this, and over 7,000 interviews, they found that the average number of emotions people think they have is 3. Angry, happy, and sad.
No.
That's really where, over the course of this many interviews, people got stuck. And again, how limiting would life be if you only had those 3 emotions, right? It doesn't, as you're saying, fully describe the spectrum of what's out there. She, in her most recent work, describes 87 emotions, which is, that's a pretty big list. And she goes into details about how they work and how they interact, and I highly recommend that. Here's a game that first time I heard again from Pat, but I think it speaks to this. How many body parts, you can just go ahead and shout this out, how many body parts with 3 letters can you name?
Leg.
Eye.
I think I heard 4, maybe 5. Okay, that's not bad. Now, what I've heard about this is that, you know, adults tend to get somewhere in the 5 to 8 range. You know, when you ask it, chat out about that. Kids do markedly better. Why do you think that is? Why would kids do better at this than adults?
They don't smell as well.
What's that again?
They
They don't spell as well. We're not limited by our conventions of spelling. Excellent. Yes. Throw off the rules. Give me the words the way I like them. I like
more it. In touch with themselves.
More in touch with themselves. Good. Okay. Wonderful.
I guess I was thinking they're learning about themselves, whereas an adult might be somebody who passed that stage and doesn't think about those things anymore.
Right. So maybe these are considered more primary.
It's the old use it, lose it kind of
sure.
thing.
Right? Yeah. I mean, the old smarter than a fifth grader show, right? I mean, it's like, oh, geez, right? You don't want to be tested on that. I understand all of that. Well, there's an idea about this that maybe has to do with the limitations we put on ourselves. But what if I gave you this? Kids might say fur or paw. How does that work? Because the original question was, Finn, how many body parts with three legs?
So the realm of anything living, kind of living organism.
Look at the question, right? I mean, how many body parts? Does it say human body parts?
No.
Right,
that's
right.
Assumption.
Good. Okay, let's look at this. How about ojo? Any Spanish speakers? Yeah, right? Is that a three-letter body part?
Yeah.
Right. Did it say no foreign? No, right? How about elbow, shin, or knee?
Yeah, because of the letters there, but the sound, yeah.
Well, it doesn't say only three letters, right? I mean, those have three letters in them, right?
Right.
So good, I'm glad you're laughing. And what's so important as we talk about this, because we're talking about limitations, right? And I think emotions fit so well in this because they're so limiting within Parkinson's, that we put these limitations on ourselves, right?
So making the box bigger.
Ah, right? Yeah, I love it.
Taking it out of the box and not having one.
Yeah, there's no more box. The box is everywhere. I love that. Really well done. That's right. It's everywhere. And that's what improv teaches us to do, is to connect and think and tap in by yes-anding and pointing to the fun. It's all there for us. We're not locked into this space. We are, in fact, ambassadors within all of this space. And it's all there for us to play with, okay? If we'll allow ourselves to, as opposed to putting in limits. Okay, emotional symphony. This usually requires a little bit bigger group, but I'm gonna do just a little bit. Let's see if we can do this. We're going to name an emotion. I need a volunteer, if that's okay. If we don't have people who want to volunteer, I don't want to put you on the spot. Would anybody like to volunteer an emotion?
I'm also asking in chat.
Yeah, exactly. So if it's out there, that I'm going to have you act out an emotion. Okay, you're going to give, like, for example, throw one at me. Throw an emotion, any emotion at all.
Perplexed.
I might personify that and be going, that might be my perplexed, okay? Now what I would ask all of you to do is join me in being perplexed in the way I showed that. You do that? Can you mirror me? Is that okay? All right, here we go. Ready? And and feel free to yes and that. Grow your perplexed state. Good. Okay, wonderful. So, is that necessarily the way I put it forward? Is that the way you would describe or express being perplexed? Not necessarily. So it's possible to have this emotion and have different people have different versions of it, right? Wow, right? So even beyond the 87, there are 87 times, how many people in the world? 8 billion now, I think the new number is? okay. That many emotions. My anger is not your anger. My sadness may not be your sadness. They might kind of touch each other in a Venn diagram way, but they're not exact replicas. And that's the importance of when someone expresses an emotion, implying an emotion, saying, I hear you, I believe you. That's the really tricky second part that we don't get to. Your perplexed doesn't make any sense to me, but I put no judgment on it. I say, I hear you, and I believe that you are perplexed. That's what you're feeling. That's the acceptance that brings them forward. And that's where playing with emotions, as we would do in this kind of game, would allow us to understand and empathize, right? There's sympathy, and then there's empathy, and then there's compassion that holds all of it together, right? And we want to play in compassion because it holds all of that connection. Okay? Questions or thoughts on emotional symphony or the value of playing with emotions? Anything at all come to you on that? If not,
well, you become closer to the person that you were seeing or trying to see if they express to you and they feel the compassion.
They feel the compassion, which allows
you to express more.
It allows you to express more. Lovely.
I was thinking about between different languages, somebody's always saying, well, what's this word in Spanish? Well, in fact, it's not the case at all that there's direct translation to a word directly in another language.
Right.
Yeah, there has to be, there's something more to it, or.
Right.
So and you're projecting what you perceive that word to be, and this other person might be operating on a whole other level.
Absolutely. We see the limited level of language because of, you know, not only foreign language, but within our own language, right? Different meanings, different dialects, different expressions. We load our words with emotions. We load them with all kinds of experience. So the possibility for missed connection, pretty great, isn't it? Unless we take the time to say, I hear you, or I heard you say, which these are games we play as well. I don't know if they're on my list, but let me finish up with this right now, and then we'll see.
We have some online emotions if we could play with one or two of those.
Would you like to throw one out?
Absolutely. We have your choice of rage, shame, confusion, awestruck, or fondness.
Who liked any of those?
I like the fondness one.
Fondness. Can you show us a little bit of fondness, what that might look or feel like? Feel free to mirror that. Beautiful. Thank you. Well done. Anyone else like any of those other words that Pat threw out there? Any other emotions?
Rage.
Rage. You want to show me some rage?
I'm not right home with you.
Oh, yes, you are. Beautiful. Good. Anybody else hear one? And by the way, it could be your own emotion or something from that list. Anybody else hear an emotion? Feel one right now, perhaps?
Confusion.
Confusion. Can you show me a little confusion? Good. Give yourselves a round of applause. How many people feel like they honestly express themselves emotionally, honestly, on a regular basis? Like you're pretty open about that regularly. You can let that out.
I don't even know that I realize it all the time.
Glad you can. And I hear you there. A lack of even understanding whether or not you do.
Depends on how deep I am in the thought about the situation that's happening.
Great. And you used the word thought again there, and I want to remind you that within improv, we're trying to really evolve past, at least within the space thought. The idea is to play, right? We want to feel more than we want to think, because thinking is that process of right and wrong. It's that logical side. And it's a great part of who we are. It's a successful part of our being and our species. It is, however, limiting if it's all we do. Remember?
So,
yeah, go ahead.
Well, I'm thinking about, I'm a speech pathologist by training, and when I teach a speech sound, there's different phases that you go through, but we're looking to reach a stage of automaticity, which means you don't even think about it. It's just something that happens.
There it is. That is a person who is, how many of you heard this before, in flow. Flow, okay? It's a concept. Mihai Csikszentmihalyi. I get bonus points for saying that. Okay. Famous Russian scientist who is much like Dr. Stuart Brown for play. Mihai Csikszentmihalyi is known for the study of flow. That feeling of, like you said, I'm totally present. You athletics, people who, you know, you're any athlete will talk about that being in the zone moment. That's flow. It's not the only way in. Improv is a great way in. If you've ever a favorite hobby, gardening, cooking, maybe reading, you can get lost in the moment, right? That flow is there for you. It is something that improv is a doorway that allows us to step into that space, okay? So it's something we do together, which is kind of a neat thing to share that flow, okay? Because now we've created it together. Again, remember, unplanned collaborative response. So it is a neat thing to do and experience that way. Good, wonderful. Thanks for those, Pat.
Came from our friends online.
No, came from our friends online. Good, good. Do we have a couple?
Yes.
Let's shout them out. Who are they?
We have Susan, Roger, Ilona, and Heather.
Susan, Roger, Ilona, and Heather. Hi. Thanks for your emotions. So I got this guy up on the screen. I want to just point him out because that is Dad. And the picture on your left there, that's Dad and I back in about 2003. And it says, "What's our story?" And that was kind of a departure point. Dad's about 2 years into his diagnosis at that moment. And we had this long-standing dream desire thing to go to see all the ballparks together, Major League Baseball parks. Mm. The next year, after rewatching Field of Dreams, I bawled my eyes out and said, "Dad, that can't be us." And so we did it. We jumped in the car and drove 2 months, 20,000 miles in the summer of 2004. We've gone on to make three documentaries, and this is a shirt because of it, and his dad is known to say, "It's just effing Parkinson's." he tries to live with that spirit of understanding, of not wanting to be stigmatized, and again, be known as a Parkinson's with persons, right, as opposed to a person with Parkinson's. So there he is there, and then the picture on the right is more recent. We did the Beta Breakers, the run in San Francisco, and Dad was a big-time runner. And of course, that's not something he can do anymore. But as I was training for this, because I'd never run before, I wanted to kind of connect with a memory of his, I saw these running chairs by Hoyt, and I contacted them, and they said, "Well, sure, you can use one," and they got it to me. And Dad got to be in the Beta Breakers for the first time in over 25 years, and it meant the world to him, and it meant the world to me. And we're running up the Hayes Street Hill right there, which is the big one in San Francisco.
Oh, yeah.
And you can see that's an authentic smiles for that run. It's about 7.5 miles. We had a great time together. He wouldn't have dreamed of that. It took a yes and to get us to that place. To, you know, could we even imagine it, see something, and then discover and transform how we could bring this into our lives. It was a yes and mentality that made that possible to do something that he thought was gone from his life. So just keep that in mind. And when we talk about stories, this is so important. Anybody know who Joseph Campbell is? You heard of him before?
Yes.
Another of my favorite people, along with Brene Brown, right? He's the guy who's known for bringing all the world's mythologies together, right? And the monomyth, one of the things he's credited with, the idea that stories, all the way back from Neanderthals on the writing of the walls to now, is that we tell the same story. No matter where we've been, no matter when we've been, we keep telling the same story. So this is that connection thing about us as a species. And we're a storytelling animal for some reason. This is how we frame our realities, is through stories. This model up there, which you may not be able to see completely well, is a 12-step process. Think of it like a map that goes round and round that you can break down most stories to. And this one is done particularly with the films in mind, so more modern. But you can play it to mythology, you know, historically as well. And I'll walk through the steps just to give you an idea. Number one is the ordinary world. Number two is the call to adventure. Number three is the refusal of that call. Number four is the meeting of the mentor. Number five is crossing the threshold. Number six, test allies and enemies. Number seven, approach to the inmost cave. Eight, the ordeal. Nine, the reward and the seizing of the sword. 10, the road back. 11, resurrection. And then 12, return with elixir. So these are the steps. And the second of my clinical trials was one called Day 1 PE Superheroes. And what I did was I got these people together online and we ran two sets of trials. The first was 27 weeks, the second was 12 weeks, where these participants, 16 in the first, 14 in the second, went through this. And they told their story. They learned about their story. Most of them only understanding the surface level of what it means to have Parkinson's in their life. These were people with Parkinson's and one care partner who joined us. And we want to make sure care partners are part of this too, because you've got a story to tell. It's not just the people with Parkinson's, it affects all of us. And by really doing a deep dive into the story, piece by piece, frame by frame, we see the connection of the stories. Doesn't mean they're all the same. That line, "You met one person with Parkinson's, you met one person with Parkinson's," that's true. And at the same time, there are pieces that go together. There's a community that can stack and go, "Yep, that's me," or "That's not me, and it's interesting." I can see how that might be, right? We have a place to put our stories to empower, to engage, to become, again, larger than what we are. And that's the point of storytelling. And it works beautifully with improvisation. Part of this program was we started every class with about 15 minutes of improvisation to build that trust, to build that ensemble, so the group would feel therefore able to express vulnerability, which is courage, by the way, for those of you who are fans of Brené's work. Vulnerability is courage, right? That's where our strength lies. So I mentioned the two sessions being completed and what we've learned. What I'd love for you to do, if you have the time, is to go to that website. And if you click on day one under esnexercise.com, there's about 22 interviews with people who have completed the program. Hear about their adventures. See if any of them relate to you. And if the program sounds interesting to you, reach out, let me know, because we'll get another cohort after I graduate in December. We'll get another group going. And we want to tell more of these stories, because all of the major groups right now, your Michael J. Foxes, to David Spinney's, to Parkinson Foundation, all of them, they want Ryan Grant here in town, they want stories. They recognize the power of storytelling to both ground us and uplift us. Well, we've got to tell not just the surface level, we've got to tell the deep level story. Okay? Who we are. That's how we become better. All right?
Can we take a stretch break?
Yep. Time for a stretch break. Let's do that. I love that you raised your hand. You're awesome. To those at home, we're taking a time out. Thank you, guys. I see. I'm at CSC Portland. I'm much better than last time I was here.
Then, may I have your laptop over here and disconnect from whatever you need to disconnect.
Do I disconnect this guy as well? Is that okay?
Yeah, I'll just plug in over here and we'll pull that for now. And then I'll take this, leave this cable here.
Given up, and this one came on the market that day, and we went and looked at it. Since we'd seen so many others, we knew that was the one. It was perfect for us. And we're glad we're there. It's got a lot of grass and trees, big trees, flowering bushes, and they're all taken care of by the condo fee.
That's pretty.
We don't have to do anything outdoors unless we want to. We don't. We can have pots of flowers and stuff. So, are you thinking of leaving Hermiston at some point?
Hopefully not, because we built a house.
Yeah. the beach, it was a two-story house, but we had a bedroom, a bathroom downstairs, which we moved. You know, we're mostly on the main floor.
Trying to technically.
Probably the last, only 4 years or so. We lived there 17 years.
I am also a speech pathologist.
15 full-time, 2 years before we retired.
I'm Charlie Clipney, I was the secretary.
It was just so much driving.
You're an attorney here, so you're 13 years.
We had doctor appointments, we had emergency.
I don't work anymore.
Or when you didn't work.
When I didn't work.
Even family events, we had to miss things.
You did horrible, so did you have.
I was with the ESD, so.
So we just wanted to be on the side.
Carol was actually the director of the program.
Anyway.
She started out at the same moment.
We used to visit Hermiston when I was a child, my grandparents. Had friends that lived there.
78, and then she came in 80, and got married in 82, and later down the road, she did the administrative stuff. And I did the OSHA stuff, and I was a practitioner in the field, so. So you know John Tracy? Oh my gosh. Incredible man. And Ernie Chrysler?
No, I mean, I specifically worked in, I worked for elder health, I worked for Providence for a long time.
Oh.
So almost always.
Purchasing and credit.
Yeah.
We did the adults in private practice.
Yeah, approving credit or not.
Otherwise, we were, I did preschool right up through high school.
You know, people that are paying their bills or not paying their bills.
I left the ESD with no why after 33 and a half years, and then I went.
So you still work, you guys retired?
I got to be my own, speech pathologist. For school district as a consultant, and it was really a wonderful experience. For preschoolers, they were trying to start a preschool program.
This is not true, sorry.
And I got to be the speech pathologist, and it was fun, but I only got to do it for a couple of, 2.5 years. Then Carol asked me to stop doing it, so.
That was a special.
And the hardest thing I ever did was give up my licenses and my seats. The seats were hard to get.
First few years, while our kids were young, I could substitute.
But I got about 40, 39, 40 years in the field, but I'm off learning about Parkinson's disease now. And your name?
It's Ruth Jenkins.
And then our daughter works at the Clapham CSD now, so with a special ed department.
Using improv in.
The program called Language and Belief.
So are you Dr. Matthew by any chance?
Yes.
So I am going to attend a 5-day course over at Eastern Oregon University, and she came there, and it was really interesting because I was going, oh, this is theater. What she was teaching, and it's because she has it was either a daughter or a son that has that experiences autism. And her book was fascinating to read about her book, and I've shared it with a lot of people over on the west side and north in Washington, so they weren't familiar with it, but that was quite an experience to be with her. And it was quite an interesting class because I'm listening to some parallels here.
Sure.
With speech pathology, and I'm thinking, gee whiz, we call that this, and so it's a really interesting group.
All right, well, I will talk to you more about that.
Are you a PSUer?
I did graduate from PSU.
Did you? So you know Frank Bender?
Oh, I sure do.
So Frank and I are friends.
That was a Frank's wedding.
It's been a recently or the very first one?
Oh, did he get remarried?
18 years.
Oh, no, I'm talking about the nice lady that started Holiday. What was it?
Yeah, Sharon Holiday.
Nice lady. I don't know that he's married.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. But I know that he's a big wig down at U of O. Anyway, and he's a good guy. So I was on my way out after 13 years with OSHA, and he was a neophyte coming in. But I was asked to be president. I just stayed with the secretary of it. It was quite the experience. I really enjoyed being in that role. I was good at it.
Good.
See you, Erin.
Long term, 5 years or more.
just a part of it.
Like that way.
Great.
So in other words, like this, Sharon.
Let's do it.
Hey, friends, we're going to try something a little different here, which is to put you in a horseshoe kind of thing. We want you to be able to see each other better, and also for the people who are online to see us. Okay?
Oh.
So we're going to move our setup here just a little, but then will that affect how they can see the screens and do they need to see? I guess if they can still see.
Yeah, I think we're ditching that for the moment.
Oh, okay.
We're trying to get people on board that they're
resisting. They're resisting. Right, the resistance is real.
Take a seat. This direction, take your
doing?
Time.
Sitting
yeah.
In the chair.
Yeah.
You've been sitting there long enough. It's time
to
sit here.
Remember, there's no right or wrong place.
Exactly. Until
yeah,
now.
Sit on the floor if you want. You
there
just
you go.
Back up
yes, Anne.
Can you come around right here?
Yeah, we're chair. Trying to horseshoe it like this.
Yes.
Sure.
So the camera
thank
face.
You.
Thank you.
Or the floor, whatever. Remember this note.
If it's
the floor,
right, it's by choice. It doesn't just happen to have.
All right, it's not like.
Yeah,
sure.
Can you, from the stage, probably ask for people to introduce themselves who come aboard here?
Sure. So, to everyone who's watching at home right now, if you are there, go ahead and introduce yourselves. And we're seeing. Oh, I see one. I see there's Susan. AKA my first follower. I see Roger. Hi, Roger. Good, good, good. And should we be able to hear them at some point?
Well, that's what I'd like to.
We're exploring. I see
Taylor
Heather.
Kennedy.
Yes.
That's Taylor Kennedy. Hi, hey, Heather.
Look at that. People getting
to
Charlie
Putney.
And Charlie saying hi. There it is. Hands reaching out, touching me, touching you in a safe way. This is good. We're getting there. We have we can see you.
So
hey, super. I can see you all.
What we're looking for is for everybody to be unmuted and try to talk to us.
So if you can go ahead and unmute
Let's ask Heather.
Heather, why don't you unmute with that awesome Rod Serling background. Unmute and talk to us through your Twilight Zone. Let's see if we can hear you, Heather. Go ahead and say a few words to us.
How you doing?
Yeah, there's Heather!
This improv is fun. I owe everything that I have to improv. Thank you.
Let's try Susan.
I think I hear Susan. Go ahead, Susan.
You heard me laughing, didn't you?
Woo, Susan.
Hi, everybody. I'm in Austin, Texas.
All right. And how about Roger?
Yes, I am all in.
Yes, we've got them all here. Outstanding. Super. Okay, very good. Now, Pat, are we able to throw our horseshoe on to that group?
Yeah.
There's the horseshoe!
Yay!
Hey,
guys!
It would not be, this is going to be really weird. It would be ideal if this were further away.
of course it would.
This is what the camera can do.
It only gets so wide.
Did you want the horseshoe to be further back?
You want
yes,
to
that's
back
exactly
is it,
so.
Can we safely do that, everybody?
Yeah.
Take
yes.
Your time.
Then I'll come and move chairs from behind you. I'm going to come through here and move some of these chairs.
You said that's how we can.
Just start it about here.
Okay.
And then it will show up here.
Oh, well, I got your stuff.
Sorry about
where's
that.
Where's Marianne?
Great.
Oh, that's right. Marianne got us in. Thank you, Marianne. I appreciate you.
That's
awesome.
And Robert.
Nicely done, Heather. Nicely done. I hope my hair grows in as cool as yours did.
After we get it shaved?
Oh, we
did. I get it shaved on a good second. Day before.
We're hybrid.
Fine, grew back.
Absolute cool word. Work
this looks great.
Okay.
Excellent work.
Okay,
how long ago, Heather?
Year and a half.
Mine was 2015.
Oh, you've had plenty of time.
I'm on my third battery.
Well, thank you, Roger.
Your third battery?
Yes. Neurostimulation. Takes about half an hour.
Wow.
That, yeah.
I'm gonna find you. There you go.
That's okay. We're here. Hey,
Is it changing your life, Heather?
Excellent. Okay. So we've been talking for the last hour or so about the general of what yes and exercise is. I have two players up there in Susan and Heather who have played this before. Roger, have I seen you in one of my classes? I'm trying to think. In one of the yes and exercise Jam for Joy, have you joined us?
I've not been live, I've listened.
You've listened.
And I listened to the film, and I'm 18 minutes into the marathon. 18 minutes, 24 seconds. And then I had to quit because I didn't want to miss this.
Well, you're very committed. Thank you, Roger. I appreciate that. I can offer at this point that Susan and Heather were part of the clinical research we've done. They both participated in the improvisation clinical trial. Susan also was part of the day one program, the first of them. And, you know, I'd prefer you guys to go ahead and say, why don't we start with Susan? You know, what are the benefits of playing with the people you play with, and what have you learned about yourself?
The opportunity to connect on a regular basis with people who really get what's going on when you have Parkinson's is so freeing. It's so much different than regular life when, you know, we move slowly or mess up our words or, you know, forget stuff. It's just been a really beautiful experience to have, understand yes and to watch it in action and to feel how that lifts us up, and you get to play.
That's been Susan's word of the year. Really good. Thanks, Susan. Heather, you came in as a noted skeptic, and you've let me know this many times, I think it's very reasonable to wonder what the heck is this about, and, you know, why would this program work? Talk to me about both your skepticism and then, you know, maybe what you're feeling now about the opportunity of improvisation with Parkinson's.
So can you hear me okay? I've done a complete 180 on this program. When I first came in, I was like, who is this guy? And how is he going to get us to do this online? I couldn't imagine improv online. And keep in mind, I didn't know what improv was. I thought that it was entertainment, exactly the opposite of what we were doing. So through this program, I've learned more to collaboration. I've learned how to enunciate and also throw the voice or keep, know when to get small. Hello, that was really hard for me. And I also really enjoyed watching the joy on everyone's face and everyone's face light up from going sort of like that Parkinson's mask to the open face. It's muditas. It's sympathetic joy that I feel doing this. So thank you so much for giving us this opportunity.
Thank you for being here, and thank you for playing. What I'd like to do is I'm going to play a round of games here, and then we'll do a round of games with our online players, and we'll just try some of this out. It's a very simple game we're going to play called Blurt. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to point to you, and you're going to say any word at all. Any word at all. There's no wrong words. Ready? Here we go. I'm going to point to you, and you just say a word.
Bell.
Good.
Ham.
Good. Perfect.
Cinnamon.
Yes.
Rhinoceros.
Super. And now let's go to our online. First round is any word at all. Susan.
Banana.
Perfect. Roger.
Will.
Yep. Heather.
Bubbles.
Perfect. Okay, good. So that's the first round where, did anybody get it wrong? No. Okay, nobody got it wrong. Y'all got it right. Good. That's really the point, right? Any word you say is the correct one. Now, this next one is a little challenging, and I know we're going to be between online, so I'm going to ask everyone to really speak with intent. Do your best to speak big, all yes and, if somebody didn't hear. And we're going to try to say the first word that relates to the last word you heard. For example, if you said, go ahead, say a word.
Rhinoceros, that's what I said.
Tusk. So he said rhinoceros, I said tusk, okay? I had no idea I was about to say tusk, but I looked at him, he said rhinoceros, I saw him charging, and I said tusk, okay? So that's what it was. Say yes and to yourself the next word you hear, okay? So So I'm gonna go down the row here, and then we'll throw it up there, and all you need to hear is the last word and respond immediately with the next word, okay? No thinking, just reacting, okay? Ready, and?
Animal.
Good.
Pen.
Right.
Cover.
Cover to Susan.
Bedspread.
Bedspread to Heather.
Paper.
Paper to Roger.
Pen.
Pen, beautiful. Give yourselves a round of applause. You cannot get to each other. Did any of you know the word you were about to say before you said it? What gave you the power to say that next word?
Creativity.
I love creativity, Roger. Beautiful. Anybody else? That's great.
You gave us permission to say whatever related.
Permission. Oh, man, that's one of my favorites. So good. And we need to give ourselves permission. We don't need someone else to give us permission, right? That's where we exercise the practice of permission. Yes, and exercise. Very good. All right, this next one is called gibberish, okay? And here's what's going to happen is you're going to use a made-up word, any made-up word at all, okay? This is not a foreign language, okay? It is a made-up language. So if you happen to speak multiple languages, please don't use one of those. You say something like, Birisok, Meximu, Bisholapipank, okay? A made-up word, loud and proud, say your gibberish, okay? I'm going to start over here. Here we go, and? Beautiful. Go ahead. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. All of it. It's a three-parter. I love it. Yes.
Cracky schnack dude.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Ooh, ba, 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 ba.
Oh, gorgeous. And?
Spilopidia.
Spilopidia. Let's run it to Roger. Gibberish.
Baby stew.
Gorgeous. Heather.
Palingina, palingina.
Yes, and Susan.
Mishinimaka.
Oh, Mishinimaka. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Again, I asked the question, did anybody get it wrong?
No.
No! You're all perfect. You're killing this thing. Wonderful. Now, what's going to happen? In gibberish, you're going to really listen to what the last person says. So that gibberish, you have to speak it nice and loud. The next person is going to repeat your gibberish and tell us what it means. For example, Ruth, if you said...
Schmacky
Frack Dew is a gorgeous caramel corn known for really fresh making. Schmacky Frack Dew. It's a beautiful caramel corn, all right? Get yourself some for the Halloween season. All right, so you repeat theirs, you put their gibberish in your mouth, and then you tell us all what it means, all right? So listen, say yes and to yourself. Here we go, and give us some gibberish, please.
Is a reason to go on vacation.
Yes, it is, absolutely. Ruth, give us some gibberish.
Yarsty Hamaboo. Yarsty Hamaboo. In Budapest, they serve this on a Viking cruise.
Yes, they do, on the Viking cruise. Carol, give us some gibberish.
Smagalaga. It's a Hawaiian vegetable dish.
It really is. It's one of the gorgeous things to do. One of the roots. Yeah. Give us some gibberish coming right over here.
Fanorpio.
Fanorpio. That's an old radio term for ham radio signaling.
Yes, it is. Ham radio signaling. Give us gibberish. You're going to hear this gibberish and you're going to repeat it. Tell us what it means. Go ahead.
Kashow.
That's exactly what it is. The boom, the kashow. Now, you're going to give me some gibberish, and she's going to translate. What is that gibberish? And Susan, translate.
Aigwe
is a dessert that's made with coffee, ice cream, and hot fudge.
Oh, come over for that later. That's gorgeous. Hey, Susan, can you give me some gibberish? Heather, translate.
What'd you call me? That was your nickname in college. That's his nickname in college.
Excellent. Heather, give me some gibberish. Roger, translate.
That was when we had a college graduation party.
Everybody give yourselves a round of applause. I'll answer for you. No, no one got it wrong. You all did perfectly. And how is it that you were able to translate these words that meant absolutely nothing? How did you do that?
Freedom to do what I wanted.
What else?
The inflection.
The inflection. You were listening to the inflection. Good. Anybody up there on the screen? How were you able to do that?
Gray matter.
Yes, gray matter. Absolutely. Susan.
No, I was just going to say freedom, but freedom.
You bet.
Yeah, we just picked up the mood.
We started off this whole shebang about an hour and a half or so ago with saying improvisation is freedom. Does that make sense to you at this point? Can you see that improvisation is freedom? Go ahead, it's more than that. What do you mean?
Freedom is limiting. You're using a word, and it's a lot more than that. A lot more elements to it, I guess.
A lot more elements.
A lot more elements.
So you're seeing the possibilities.
And it's a perception, and even the perceptions, they're endless.
Yes, yes. Your perceptions, your abilities to perceive the world are limitless. I love that. That's really great. That's where you tap into your power. That's where you open yourself back up to your power and creativity and how you choose to frame the world around you. And by the way, that includes not only your perspective, but the way you allow people to relate to you and you relate to others. You create realities by doing that, by owning that. That is yours, okay? Good. Other questions?
I just wanted to mention, it's not a mechanical thing or anything that we're parroting or memorizing or trying to be or do. It forces us into mindfulness right in the moment, right here, right now. And what's better than that?
Yes, Susan.
Without judgment. That is the icing on the cake.
Great. Without judgment. Being here and accepting that space. Why is being in a space without judgment important in order to see the possibility? Why would that matter? I see Roger. Yes, Roger.
I was going to say intentional unlocking our thought process.
Yeah. Yes.
Absolutely. We had to be intent to come up with an answer. But we unlock our whole brain because there's no wrong answer.
Well said, Roger. Unlocking our whole brain, okay?
That's great.
Yeah, do you guys agree with that? And why does it matter to be in that place of complete acceptance of that, of unconditional positive regard for you, Carl Rogers fans? Why does it matter to be in that place?
So you feel safe.
What's that again?
So you feel safe.
You feel safe. I heard that. That's great.
Feel good about yourself and others.
Feel good about yourself and others. Beautiful. Good. Anybody else? Why is it important?
On screen.
On screen. Who's got a hand for me? Susan.
Yeah. You know what self-confidence? You catch that?
Sorry, it froze. I heard builds up confidence and go again.
Yeah, self-confidence, the fact that we have so much freedom, that there's no wrong answer for those people who might be insecure or whatever.
Great.
Over time, really gives you the sense from within that it's okay to go ahead and give it a shot.
That's what it is. It's It's okay to give it a shot. You give yourself permission. You see these recurrent themes. Remember that list of words we saw at the beginning? It looked like probably a whole slew of what the heck words, right? Some of those words have popped up and interwoven their way through what we've done today. And that's not because of me. That's just me observing. I got that list over time by listening to all of you play. These are things you repeatedly say, themes you point to, right? Kind of like Joseph Campbell knowing the 12 steps of the journey. These are the, you know, the power words and phrases that help us become larger selves through play, through having fun, through love and acceptance and safety, respect, all of those things. Okay, good. How are we doing on time, Pat?
It is 5:31, Robert.
5:31. Okay, good. Let me look at the game list and see what game pops right now. I got a couple ideas, but I want to make sure. Let's go with last letter, next word. This is another example of not knowing what's coming next. Okay? So we're going to start by saying a word, and you have to listen and speak clearly. The last letter of that word is going to become the first letter of the next word. Like if I said elephant, next word would be theory, right? Could be, because the T at the end of elephant could lead to the T at the beginning of theory. So each of you are going to say a word, and you're going to pass that word, and you're going to grab the last letter to make the first letter of your next word. We'll start here, okay? Carol, give me a word. You're going to point to Ruth. Go ahead.
Salamander. Rear. Radishes.
Tomato.
Opulent.
Opulent. Opulent to Susan.
Zito.
Heather. Oh, you're muted, of course, dear. I couldn't hear you. I think you're lost in space. Oh, no. You're dropping pearls, and they're floating out into the Rod Serling Twilight Zone. Susan, repeat your word, and Roger's going to give us the next one. Go ahead, Susan.
Tomato.
Tomato to Roger.
Octopus.
Oh, good. Octopus. Octopus to Heather. I'm going to say that she said salamander. I don't read lips well. She's like, that's not what I said, Robert. I'm so sorry, Heather. We're having technical issues. However, I know you said wonderful, brilliant things, and you'll get full credit, plus 3 gold stars for all your efforts. Okay. Good job. So, thank you very much. Okay, so how do you know what the next word's going to be? How do you know?
You get to choose.
You get to choose, right? All you've got is a letter, though.
Yeah.
Right? So I'm going to do this next thing. I'm just going to throw a letter your way, and you're going to say the next word. Ready? Here it comes. J.
Jab.
Good. B.
Bus.
L.
Lascivious.
Good. M.
Mummy.
O.
Avocado.
Perfect. Heather, your letter is B.
Baboon.
Ah, she's got volume. Baboon, baboon. And Susan, your letter is T.
Tangerine.
Tangerine. Gorgeous. Okay. Here's what I want you to do. I want you to take those letters, and I want you to give them as a gift to somebody. Okay? I'm gonna, for example, Susan's going to start, and she's going to give to Heather. You're going to give her the gift of a letter. And then Heather's going to take that letter and make some kind of food, it looks like. She's going to take that letter and say, thanks for the gift. I needed this. Like if the gift was, for example, here's a bee. Oh, good. I've been looking for a balloon for the party. Okay? So whatever the letter is, you're going to say thank you for the gift. And then Heather, by the way, you're going to gift a letter back to Susan. We're going to watch this go back and forth. Okay? Susan, go ahead and gift a letter to Heather. Heather, receive the gift, identify it, and then give her a gift back. Go.
I have an H for you.
H. Oh, I needed an H. Thank you. This is for the hors d'oeuvres for your party, or horsey derbies, whichever you prefer.
Good. Now give a gift to Susan. So Heather, give a gift to Susan. Give her a letter.
I gave her H like hors d'oeuvres.
Oh, you're going to give her the back. H back because she gave you the H. You can give her an H back. Make sure she knows this H is for you.
Oh, sorry. This H is for you. The hors d'oeuvres are for your party or horsey derby.
Hooray, hooray, hooray. I needed an H.
Great. Susan, give her another letter.
Heather, I have a Q for you.
A Q. I would like to use this to give you back a question. This is for you, a question, Q.
It's a bit of a query in the head.
Query, that's it, yeah. All right, give a round of applause. So they're playing a game, right? The game is passing the letter, right? And the letter is a gift, right? We talk about giving gifts because that immediately, by being accepted in a yes and way, nobody said, here's a B. No, I don't want a B. Yes, but I'd prefer a C. Neither of those things were said. I got a B, wonderful. I needed a bonnet for my B. That's what I got the B for, okay? Cute, good. Now, that was a little different, and it's never wrong, it happens all the time, than I had in mind for how the game would go. What I would say is, let's try it this round here, is when you receive a letter, transform it, you know, you do whatever it is, and then pick a different letter to give back to your partner. Let's try that, okay? So can I have two volunteers for a letter gift, as it were? Who would like to play? Yes, we have one player who would like to play. There we go. So you two are just going to call out to each other. You're going to go ahead and you're going to, first of all, what's your name?
Charlie.
Charlie, and your name?
Star.
Star. Charlie meets Star. Star meets Charlie. Hello.
Hi.
Beautiful. Charlie, offer a letter to Star, and Star will make something out of it, and then she'll offer you a different letter. You'll make something out of that. Go ahead, Charlie.
Hey, Star. Star, I got something for you.
What is it?
Just hold on. I gotta unwrap it. Be careful now. All right? Are you ready? Here it goes. This is an X.
Wow.
This is an X.
Wow, that's so unusual.
There it is, right here. There's the X.
Thank you.
It's yours.
Great. I've been studying Xerxes for quite a while.
Yourself. You really did. You said yes to the offer, first of all, and then you said yes to what's next. You said, yes, x-ray, and what else, right? You said, there's more X's out there, and I'm going to play my way into it. And by the way, keep engaging Charlie as I'm doing this. And there it was for you. Eventually, you opened yourself to what's in the box, and it was Xerxes. All right, would anyone else here like to try a round before I throw it up to my screen partners of the letter gift? Would anyone else like to try the letter gift? I'll give you a chance. I can come back to you if you're hesitating. It looks like we have players. Ruth and Carol are going to play this round. All right, Ruth, why don't you offer a gift of a letter to Carol? Carol will do something with it, and then she'll offer you a different letter. All right, take it away.
Carol, it has been so long since I've seen you. And I understand that your birthday is coming up, so I got you a D.
A D? My goodness. My birthday is a special day for me, so I'm going to share something with you.
Do you want to tell me anything about the D?
I guess I better, so that you understand what it is. It might not be able to tell it, but it's a donut.
My favorite!
No? I'm supposed to give you something, right?
A new letter.
A new letter? You have to have this one.
Oh. One of my favorites. Yes. And it's great because I have always wanted my own pet ostrich.
Ostriches! All right! Give a round of applause! All right, I'm going to throw it up to the screen right now. Who would like to play a game of letter gifts, as I throw it that way? Roger's going to play and Susan's going to play. Okay, we'll get you in, Heather, don't worry. Roger and Susan, Roger, why don't you start by offering a letter gift to Susan? Take it away.
I love beautiful rainbows, so I'm giving you an R.
Really?
Yes, they are very real.
Real rainbows, thank you. I'm so excited, thank you. And I have a present for you in return. A W.
Repeat.
W. It's a W.
Yes, I love W's because they tell me we will win.
Yes. Woo! Woo! Well done, Roger. Beautiful.
Oh.
Yeah. All right, Heather, are you ready to play?
Yes, sir.
Would anyone else like to play with Heather?
I can see now.
We're going to do an interconnected screen. Oh, there you are. Okay, I'm sorry. What is your name?
Joanne.
Joanne, and this is Heather. Heather, this is Joanne. Okay, you can find each other on the screen. Joanne, wave hi. There she is.
Joanne.
Joanne, nice and loud. Go ahead and tell Heather what gift you brought her.
Oh, Heather, hi. I brought you this beautiful little letter L.
An L. Oh, thank you. That's just what I needed to finish my band. I'm so excited. I needed an L. I have drums and bass and guitar. In fact, I'm going to give you back a gift of a G.
Oh,
here you go. This is for you, a G.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I always wanted a gorilla of my very own.
Very good. Good. Now, Heather, you got an L. What word would associate with L with that gift? What could you make specifically out of that gift of the L?
I'm going to do something like an LA dancer for my backdrop and my you know, because my band doesn't have any go-go dancers, so I was going to get like an LA girl doing some dancing.
Perfect. We got gorillas and LA dancers all together. Give them a round of applause. Well done. Okay, good. Sir, did you want to try gift-giving a letter? Would you like to try that with me, perhaps? Okay. I'm going to give you a letter, and you're going to change it into something, and then you're going to give me a letter, okay? And what's your name again? Okay, I'm Robert. Here we go. My gift for you, and I've been saving this one, Everyone's going to be very jealous right now because it's, this is a C, and it is for you. Here is a C. Secret notes when I wasn't looking? How did you know what to do with those letters once they were given to you? There it is. You're so expressive. I love that, Joanne. That's great. This is a great answer to that. Good. Anybody else? And by the way, it doesn't have to be verbal. It can be expressive. It can be physical, what your answer is. How did you know what to do with that letter? I see Heather. She's expressing it. I see Roger's expressing it. That's good. We can all physically express. Yes. That's good. This is freedom. Well, I'd suggest, and perhaps, you know, you can tell me what you think of it, that you knew because you trusted yourself. That next thing was there for you. It's always there for you. You are all natural born improvisers. It is your birthright. You've always had it. It is laid dormant in some of you. However, it doesn't have an expiration. It's ready for you at any given time. And that's what I really want to underline, is that it is, like anything else, a skill that can be developed through practice. And here's the really good news. That practice is play. It's fun. There's laughter. There's community. There's meeting people from all over the world at once. And we're getting a small taste of that because we do this online regularly. And as we develop with our friends and partners and throughout comedy sports, we'll bring it locally too. So I just want to make sure you guys know this is here for care partners, people with Parkinson's, medical wellness providers. And by the way, when I say care partners, anybody who's been touched by Parkinson's at all, any family member or friend or anybody else, this is for you to bring that forward, okay? Because we want to share this gift with each other that says, I feel good about this, and this can lead to infinite numbers of connections, both internally and externally, all right? So with that, are there any questions or comments about what Yes and Exercise is or how you can get involved if you'd like to? Great. Yes and Exercise is a nonprofit 501c3, newly formed. It's online, yesandexercise.com. Right now we're offering regular Tuesday morning classes. They're free. Okay? We have the Pay It Forward model, which was given to us by the Parkinson Voice Project, doing the same thing, which is basically if you come and enjoy and you can pay for the next student or you just want to offer something financially, great. Never have to. You can also pay it forward by sharing the program with other people. Say, hey, look, I have this great thing. It's really fun. We just don't want it to die. We don't want your enthusiasm to be like, that was great, and then it goes away. Find a way to pay it forward, okay? That's how we exist in that regard. And yes, it is at yesandexercise.com, okay? So that's who we are. It's a great question. Thank you. Are there other questions about either how you can access or anything that you've heard today about the program?
Well, like, we're not going to remember all these fun games. And yeah. So is there a way to access that on that?
Yesandexercise.com is the hub. Everything's there. If you remember nothing else but yesandexercise.com, and I'm so sorry, I don't have my cards with me, I normally do, but yesandexercise.com, that's the place. And it has my contact information. It has how to sign up to the classes. It has information on the day one program. And again, we're very new, and I am focused on finishing my PhD, so offerings are a little limited. The goal is by, you know, after graduating 2023 here in January, this is my full time, this is what I do. I'll offer classes all over. And by the way, if you have family members or groups, you're like, hey, you know what? Minimum six people, maximum 16. We have an hour of time. Can we get a group online? Yeah, you bring me the people, I can get you, you know, I will facilitate that for you, and we'll play so they can see what's in it for them. Okay? So, you know, that's a great way to get people involved, and that could be in the professional realm in terms of medical wellness, that could be your friends, that could be an office group, whoever, because Parkinson's reaches across all areas of life. It's not a bubbled thing, right? We want to bring this communication tool, this creativity tool, right, to all realms, make it accessible. Great. Other questions, either about the program or a comment about anything, if you've seen something and want to offer that. I see Susan.
I would like to give you guys the perspective of time. I've been hanging around with Robert for more than 2 years, and there are two letters of the alphabet that seem to show up a lot in this work. One of them is C. And Heather and Robert, you can help me with this, but communication and community and connection and conversation.
Calamity?
Yeah.
Challenge.
There you go. Right, it is. Yes. And that's so awesome, Roger, for building up from within. The other letter is F. We celebrate all the F words in this group. We get past our fear of failure. We have fun.
Oh, those F words.
Flight.
Or freeze, as happens.
Yes.
And fun and fickle and
freedom.
Phenomenal. Oh, wait, that's not right.
Fantastic.
There you go. Yesandexercise.com. It's all right there.
Whoa, great one.
Thank you, Susan. Thank you, Heather. Thank you, Roger.
Can I also mention one more thing?
You certainly may.
If you think that it's easy to do improv with a mask on and through Zoom, I dare, double dog dare you to try it, because what you're doing is you're cutting off half of your ability to communicate. So Robert's only using his eyes to communicate, if you think about it. Of course, you can hear him through the mask, but on sight, that's what we tend to respond to, right? The sight cues. See, look at that. Yes. Right? I mean, it's really not easy to do this, especially with people who have facial masking. So I can tell you that if you're worried about facial masking as a Parkinson's person, like I am, this will help you, and it will also help you to be working on your dopamine. It'll enhance dopamine. Thank you so much for that too.
Thank you. And again, it's an additive. I think what you know is so nice what you're saying, Heather. This is something, it's motivating the better parts of you that may be lying dormant. You produce your own dopamine. Of course, you're taking it medically, and we're happy for the pharmaceutical, you know, that exists. This is bringing forth those things that already lie within you that just say with aviators, yes and.
You're such a bright light. I had to put these on.
Thank you, Heather.
I heard that, aviators.
I see Ruth has something. Yes, Ruth.
What time on Tuesdays?
So right now we're scheduled for 10 a.m. on Tuesday mornings. That is Pacific time.
10 a.m.
And it does not have to be our only time. We've had the good fortune over the last couple of weeks of selling out because we capped 16. And by selling, I just mean that all the spots are taken. I mean everyone, no one had to pay. We can offer more classes if I know I have a minimum number. So again, if you're bringing me people, you're saying, hey, 8 of us are going to show up at, you know, 6 o'clock on a Tuesday. I'll find a Tuesday for that, okay? So we can try it out. Because this is relatively new still, and I really want people to know that we're here to play together. I'm happy to say that in over 2.5 years of experimentation since COVID brought us its world, this works better than I thought it would have. Really wouldn't have thought about improvisation online. And doing it this way has been a big part of my research, both with the help of my friends at Comedy Sports and what I've done within the research at UNLV, see how these things meet. It really is lovely. And we have players from around the world, which is really nice too, that you get on the screen at any given time. We have friends from the UK, friends from Israel, friends from all across the US and Canada. We have some friends from New Zealand who will be joining us soon. So what a lovely thing to join people. We had a woman who was getting up at 3 a.m. over in the UK to play with us because she just loved it so much and there was nothing like it. So we know there's something here and it matters. And that's what we want to do, is keep inspiring all of you to be your best you. Okay? Any other questions? I know we're probably at about time.
So you just send a Zoom link? Is that how you do it?
Yeah, when you sign up, you get a Zoom link automatically. So that's the one. And it's under there, under, I'm guessing, an exercise, sign up, and then, you know, it'll give you that. That's right. We do it through Zoom. Good. Any other questions? I want to make sure everybody, I see Susan. Yes, Susan?
Not next week. Not next Tuesday.
Not, that's right. Not next Tuesday, because next Tuesday I will be up in Vancouver. We actually have another event, PD Avengers, Larry Gifford, if any of you know him, as well as Tightrope Theater, Dan Doomsh's group, is putting on another improv event. So you're welcome to come and live stream like what we're seeing our friends do here. The information about that is on our website, yesandexercise.com. So yeah, there won't be the next regularly scheduled one is on August 2nd, I believe. Yeah, Tuesday, August 2nd. I have these 2 weeks off for the roadie here. But once you get signed up too, I've warned my friends, hey, there may be pop-up improv. You never know, so let me know. Yes, Roger?
I would like to suggest this exercise is neuroplastic, which gives you the benefit of neuroprotective.
From your word, from your lips right there to my professor's ears, may they hear that. It's neuroprotective. Love that. Thank you, Roger. That's a great way of saying it. Neuroplastic.
You could put that in writing.
Yeah, I like it. You come with the best writing. You really do. And I'm happy to yes and it into the research. So thank you for that. Neuroplastic and therefore neuroprotective. Very good, Roger. Good. Anybody else? I thank you all for your time. It's been a joy playing with you. I hope you had fun. Yeah? Okay. Well, good. Don't let this be the last. Let us play again soon, okay? Let's thank our hosts. Let's thank Comedy Sports. Thank you so much. Let's thank all of our friends on the screen for joining us. Susan, Roger, and Heather, thank you so much. And please, again, come to the website, yesandexercise.com. Lots to explore there. And again, you're what makes this program work. It's you. All of yous. Okay. Yeah. Point to the fun. Okay. Have a great evening. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.